Just we, on behalf of party, the GNA, got a mandate from the people for the last 6 decades. And at the last election, even the people recommend his support and give them mandate to finding a political solution. That's an important one. He lost many hundred thousand lives are lost, even the lives. That is important one. And also, we got a mandate to rebuild our areas, disrupted area, inviting the investments from donor countries, from diaspora people, and who are interested to come here and invest the investments. There is a need of our in our areas. Therefore, we got a mandate from our people to do it. And as well as the building of the economy, along with the new economy order in the world, that is the globalization and the market economy. We have to follow. On the line, we have to build up our economy in our areas to meet in the world challenges in the economic development. I unfold what is our manifesto and get a mandate from the people. The Tamil who fled the country must be permitted to return to their homes and a conducive atmosphere created for their return. In particular, expeditious steps must be taken for the return of over 100,000 refugees in South India. A comprehensive program for the development of the North and East, including the creation of employment opportunities. That's what particularly this our governor also mentioned in his speech, in this innovation. For the youth will be undertaken with the active support of the Sri Lankan state, the Tamil diaspora and the international community. It was not possible to implement such a program during the term of the former regime due to its negative attitude, and since January 2015, the country had not had a strong and stable government. We all know the last January 15th of 2015, with understanding of the international community, our Tamil-speaking people, Tamils, Muslims, and the Tilkari Tamils are together supported to change the government and elect a new opportunity to give into a new government. That's very important. The TNA would actively promote the accomplishment of such a program when a new government is established. A comprehensive development program will be undertaken in the Northeast, including upgrading the Palai Airport and an international airport. We have come to an agreement with the Prime Minister and the government to accept the regional airport. However, we are discussing about the matter for further development and developing seaports and the fisheries harbors. The relevant expertise and technologies will be obtained as so to modernize the utilization of our Palmyra resource, very important. That is our asset in our Yucatan Peninsula particularly. We will find solutions for the challenges faced by our fishermen in 3D pursuing their vocation and make every effort to improve their livelihood. The war has left behind almost 9,000 widows in the northern and northern east. There's a need for a clear policy to build their capacity and uplift their lives. These widows have become economically and socially vulnerable. Adequate steps must be taken to swiftly and effectively create livelihood programs and the necessary measures to alleviate the present condition. The need of children, elders and disabled also need to be addressed. The rehabilitation and reintegration into the social fabrics of ex-militants has also been very much interested and indicated by our honorable governor. Ex-militants, more than 12,000, between 15,000. Ex-militants must be comprehensive, ensuring their acquisition of necessary skills and the creation of employment opportunities to enable them to recommence life with their dignity. Programs that have been implemented, that's why have been inadequate, and the ex-militants have not been able to earn their livelihood. or recommends their life dignity as early programs of action is needed to address this issue. Therefore, this is our accordance. This is our manifesto for which we got a mandate from our people to find a political solution as well to build up an economy in order to prosperous of our people in our distracted area particularly. This is our honorable governor mentioned the cement factory in KK's that is started in 1950s, but now the story is disrupted and abolished. Our Prime Minister and we have fruitful discussion, but did we start that, once we start the cement factory in the same place, we are unable to provide limestone in from our area. The limestone and the clay from Bhutan is a basis component to produce the standard cement. But the problem is in our areas, particularly the Jakarta Peninsula, the limestone is not available for the future construction of building a packing of cement. Even in the 50s, every day, more than 3 years, the train compartments transported several thousands of load of clinker that is after the burnt of clay and limestone to goal area for packing and giving employment. Now we are able to take or digging for limestone that is very difficult because there's an environment issue, underground water issue, there's no land for more digging of limestone is the main problem we are having. Not to haul a water to start up sake or innovate the cement factory in the same place. Even last week, I had the opportunity to discuss with the matter with the Honorable Prime Minister regarding the cement factory, regarding the airport, and the other industrial avenues. We have a couple of agreements. The cement factory area will be a light industrial area. We put up light industries in those areas. And we find some places like Pornavali in the Kudagri area, there's a potential of limestone. We are able to discuss the matter to build up a cement factory on those areas. We wanted any large quantity of cement for new constructions, renovation. This is very important. We are spending money to send to outstations, other countries to purchase the cement packets. We produce cement in our own area. We try our best. Otherwise, we bring, that's like coal plants and the limestone from outside, likely in India. That's why I'm not thinking about that. But the Pornavali in the Kudagri area is very much important and potential to start a cement factory. Our diaspora people also discuss with us to invest. Even the person from outside diaspora, to construct a paper factory in the Eastern Point. But that opportunity not be given. There's a lot of we mentioned in our manifesto, in our mandate, to invite the persons who are interested to invest here from the diaspora and other donor countries, other investors are willing to come and invest to build up our disrupted area for giving employment, giving our opportunity to employment and build up the economy to meet the challenges of the world developments. Very much we welcome and thank you for them, especially from outside our, on behalf of people here. Honorable, I first thank you, the Honorable Governor, to make this forum. This is a good morning to start that forum for finding ways and means to invest and way of investment. What are the areas we have to invest and build up of economy and giving employment opportunities in our particular areas.